come so fast, but at the same time, it could have come a lot sooner. Today, we've been together for 2,027 days, and I couldn't be more proud of our history. I thank God for you as often as I can. He has given me my best friend and life partner. Through his grace, mercy, and love towards us, as Shakespeare would put it, I would not wish any companion in the world but you. We have been able to go through so much together because of him and the love he has allowed us to share. On the night that we decided to be boyfriend and girlfriend, sitting on the hood of my car in the high school parking lot, we decided that the purpose of our relationship would be to glorify God. Now, over 5.5 years later, I'm standing before you so excited that we are solidifying that goal of our relationship with our marriage. Our marriage will get to be a sign of the gospel, of how much God loves us and everyone on earth. I couldn't pick a more caring, loving, generous, self-giving person to commit to that with. I'm so thankful that God has called us into a lifetime of ministry together. And I'm so excited that today we finally get to start down that path, surrounded by God and our family and friends.
Courtney, over the years you have become my light. You help me look at God with clarity, myself with honesty, and everyone with compassion. Spending time without you is like trying to see in pure darkness. But your presence makes everything more beautiful. You're the crown of my head, the best of my life. Your beacon of never-fading encouragement brought me here alive, and now I'm giving that life back to you under the authority of our King Jesus.
What I saw in him was a passion for Christ and a love for people that couldn't be quenched. Not too long after that, I met Courtney at a fall festival at our church, and right away I saw a beautiful young woman who was full of joy and had the most infectious smile you have ever seen. And I remember thinking to myself, you know, she's so sweet. Does she really know what she's getting herself into? But the moment that I knew that Bailey was going to marry Courtney, and this was long before he had figured this out, was when Bailey told me that he had figured out that if he timed it right and listened nonstop, he could listen to the entire Bible in the course of 1 week over spring break. I said, well, that sounds like a pretty good idea, but what about Courtney? And he said, well, Courtney's going to listen with me. And it was in that moment that I knew that God was working together something very special. He was bringing together a very special couple who were going to be united together, but united together in a unique way, that they would be united together before him.
If the head I of our marriage and the source of our love. Hello, I promise to sacrifice my comfort, pleasure, and my whole life to make you feel loved and taken care of. Say I promise to forgive you constantly, as Christ has forgiven me, to keep no record of your wrongs, and to love and accept the present faulty version of yourself. I promise to be quick to listen, slow to speak, and slow to anger. I promise to trust your leadership, knowing that you will do your best to follow God's will for us. I promise to show you that I love and respect you in my actions and in my words. I promise to love and serve you as the church loves and serves our Father. I promise to do my best to support and encourage you in our best days and in our worst. And I vow in the presence of our true God and our loving friends and family to love you in all circumstances, and to fight for that love for the rest of
life. I promise to maintain myself as a useful instrument to God, the head of our marriage and the source of our love. I promise to sacrifice my comfort, pleasure, and my whole life to make you feel loved and taken care of. I promise to forgive you constantly, as Christ has forgiven me, to keep no record of your wrongs, to love and accept the present faulty version of yourself. I promise to be quick to listen, slow to speak, and slow to anger. As your priest, I will lead you well by being closely led by God. You. As your prophet, I will search hard for God's direction in all our decisions. And as your protector, I will keep you out of needless danger and harm with the power of God. Courtney, I promise to never stop telling you you're beautiful, even when you're old and gray. I promise to only ever touch you with warmth and affection. And I promise to strive hard to build in you a sense of security and a foundation for confidence. If I ever get the nerve, I vow in the presence of our true God and our loving friends and family to love you in all circumstances and to fight for that love for the rest of my life.
Cause honey, your soul could never grow.